Hello, everyone. I'm Marty L. Ward here with our Tag Talk with Marty. So it's getting close to Valentine's Day. So everyone is thinking about love. And that's something wonderful to think about each and every day. To love ourselves. You know, and that sounds so simple, right? And, you know, just love yourself. I went through a very difficult time in my life where I went from the very top to the very bottom of success. And all during that time, people would say to me, "Oh, Marty, you know, just love yourself. Just believe in yourself." Hey, Raymond. Thanks for joining. You know, and I would think, well, no kidding. Of course we know to love ourselves. But how do we do that? You know? So it looks like Raymond loves himself because he, the way he reads and spelling. So he loves some of his talents, abilities, and gifts, which is exactly what we need to do. So what I discovered when I went through that very difficult time and people were telling me to love myself and I didn't know how, no one had ever taught me, I realized that I needed to unlock my talents, my abilities, and my gifts. And what happened is I did that. And once I realized that how talented, able, and gifted I was, well, then I could see that that was a reason to love myself. Because we just keep saying, well, just love yourself. You can think why, based on what. But when you see how valuable you are, that the way you express yourself, whether that's as a teacher, as a parent, as an artist, as a singer, as a dancer, as a writer, as an engineer, as someone who takes care of people in a store, a nurse, whatever it is that you do to express who you are, that's your talent. And your ability, and we talk about this here often, you know, your ability is creative, inventive, imaginative, analytical, athletic, coordinated, flexible, adaptable. You see, we have all of these inside of us. And the children have all of these inside of them. And then the gift that we give is we combine our talent with our ability and we give our gift to the world. And the gift you give is as a parent, nurturing, supporting, caring. You make learning fun for them. You bring them together as a cook, which is a talent, which I don't have. I don't have that one. But as a cook, you bring your family together. You have good times at the dinner table. You talk about different topics. You know, that's the gift that you give them through your cooking. You bring people together. As a singer, you know, your children bring you joy, artist, their beauty of the work that they do is the gift that they give, right? Even when you have someone who's the jokester, you know, their ability is a sense of humor and their gift is bringing joy to everyone. And so it's really looking at the gift that you are, the gift that each child is. And that's how we can begin to love ourselves based on the reality of actually who we are and what we do, what your children do, right? Maybe they play soccer, maybe they build blocks, right? And they love to build and wow, that's a talent of theirs. Maybe they're an organizer or you're an organizer and a planner, right? To get everything done, whether it's a teacher, as a parent, planning and organized. What's the gift of that? Well, keep things moving. You have the classroom goes more smoothly. The home runs more smoothly. You solve problems every minute. Think of that. As every minute as an adult, you are solving problems. And your children are too. So you can say to them, wow, you are a problem solver. Look at how you solved that problem and you figured out how to get that sandwich in that plastic bag and put it in your backpack. You are a problem solver. So as we point out to ourselves first, the gift that we are, and then to our children, the gift that they are, each and every day, and to see their expression of who they are in that moment is them expressing their talent, ability, or gift. And when we can see a child's most annoying behavior as a signpost of their greatest gift and point it out to them, well, what we do in that moment is we build self-confidence. They start to see that they are valuable, that being them matters. And as they do that, then they can love themselves based on the reality of who they are. So an annoying behavior could be something like a child speaking up to you, you know, telling you that they're not going to do it and this is why they're not going to do it and they're going on. And that can be, you know, feel threatening and annoying. But if you take a deep breath and say, wow, I really respect that you are standing up for yourself. You know exactly what you want. Good for you for knowing exactly what you want. And right now is not the time for that to happen. Let's see when we can have a time that that could be possible. So what you did is you tagged them by saying that they were brave just to be able to speak up to you, that they were saying what they thought and what they believed. And isn't that what we want our children to do? We want them to be able to speak up. We want them to be able to say what they want so that they can keep themselves safe as they get older. So by telling them, wow, good for you, and I can't do that right now. So you can hang on to yourself while you also are building their self-esteem and their self-love. So this week, think about ways in which you are a gift to your children. Children in your classroom, children at home. Think of your talents, abilities, and gifts that you have that make you lovable, that make you that person that you are. And then see your children, each and every one, as expressing their talents, abilities, and gifts, and how you can support their self-love by pointing them out. And if you'd like some guidance with this, I'm doing a Valentine's Day special to work with people who would like to really understand this. And I'm doing it at a very special Valentine's price, just $47 to work with me for 45 minutes to an hour. And when you leave, you're going to feel great about who you are. You're going to know exactly what your talents, abilities, and gifts are, and why you can value yourself. And as you do that, then you can take it home and you can do it with your children. So it's going to be a special gift that you can give yourself to feel good about you, and then also something you can use with your children to have them feeling good about themselves. So I'll put the link below the video so that you can give this Valentine's Day special to you or to someone you love so that you can feel good. And we're raising money to support giving teachers our training for free So you'll be supporting the nonprofit Confidence Build Success Academy that provides training for teachers here in America for free. So have a wonderful week and enjoy your love for yourself.